Figures and up. When you get it out the mud, it hit different. You should sell when the cops came, we hit fences. Now I'm blowing smoke out the country with two thick. I'ma take them both back to the penthouse and get. That's how it's supposed to be. Life is beautiful. I'm doing won't believe. Flew out to Colombia and brought me home some. Used to be the underdog. Now they put me overseas. And I don't want to be nobody else, nigga. Do me like I do me. And I don't care to be nobody else, cause I'm unique. I'm fine with me. I am God and God is me. Dream so big, might die in my sleep. But I ain't running from it. It's only a loss if you ain't learned nothing from it. I turned to a boss. Remember I was under budget. Now I pay the staff off and fly them to another country. It's for the love of the game, never for the love of money. I used to wanna be like Wayne. I used to wanna be like Nip with the Cuban link chain. I used to rap like Jay, trying to make me a name. Now all I do is C5. And I'ma stay in my lane. I could do anything I put my mind to, that's facts. I wanna be a dealer, so I start. I like, so I went on and start flipping packs. I heard the drought three and said, dog, I'm a rap. I did that, superseded expectation. I refuse to settle for anything less than greatness. I'm the hottest rapper on the west, let's just face it. So put that pride to the side, then let's get paper. Can't nobody do me like I do me. And I don't care to be nobody else, cause I'm unique. I'm fine with me, I am God and God is me. Dream so big, might die in my sleep, but I ain't running from it. It's only a loss if you ain't learned nothing from it. I turn to a boss, remember I was under budget. Now I pay the staff off and fly them to another country. It's for the love of the game, never for the love of money.
Bars, C5, just incredible. Hunger Flow 2.
We are about 15 or so miles northwest of world-famous Miami Beach as we are set for football at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami Gardens. Today we've got a Week 6 matchup for you here, as it'll be the Carolina Panthers taking on the Miami Dolphins. Set to go now in Week 6 of the NFL season, and we are underway on EA Sports. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
The Dolphins take over first and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
Now the rookie third-round pick. It's Devon Achane. And he tried to bounce it outside, but they'll stop it behind the line. It'll go as a loss of a yard on the game's first play. Second down. You look at this Carolina defense. And this unit, very tough to throw against. Currently second best in the NFL.
Yeah, defending the pass hasn't been an issue for them. It's been stopping the run. And if they don't stop the run, they can't get back to their strength, which is guarding against the air attack.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Again, it's Achane. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. 8 yards there on the carry, and now they're left with a much more manageable third and three.
On a second and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long-distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yards to put themselves in a good spot on third down.
Call it a gain of 7, and it gets them a new set of downs. Now a play fake. Here's Tagovailoa. That's to the sideline and it's intercepted. Dante Jackson picks it, and the Panthers are going to get the football here as they force the INT on the game's opening drive. Well, that is a quick lesson on how difficult this defense is to throw against an interception on their initial drive of the ball game.
Now we know why their offensive staff spent the entire week awake trying to prepare for this one, because you can't totally shy away from throwing the football. But at the same time, you're looking at them and going, where are the weaknesses? How are we going to move it?
One of the top defenses in the NFL for a reason. We just saw one example right there. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. This defense for the Dolphins, they were very strong in the win last week over the Giants.
Yeah, what stood out to me on tape? The way they were flying to the football. So that tells me that they've got all their assignments down and they're playing with extreme confidence.
That throw by Young incomplete.
I tell you what, that's a veteran play from the guy his first season in the NFL. A lot of rookies are trying to pull something there. He thought better of it, and that was the right decision.
They tried the throw on second down, unsuccessful. Now it's third and one.
Check, check.
They'll try and run for it with Sanders. And I don't think he got there. No, they stop it right where it all started. Nothing doing on second and third down after that 9-yard gain on first. So on fourth down, here's Johnny Hecker to punt it away. Back deep is Tyreek Hill. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And their opening drive, that ended with the interception. Fortunate, though, it didn't lead to points.
It didn't lead to points, and because they kind of got away with one, maybe you come back and throw something similar again to show that you're not afraid, that you're not going to back down, and take your shot. Let the defense know that you're going to be there all game long.
Second and 9 now from the 21. Tua sets up to pass it. Getting this out to the flat, Mostert. And he's upended after a gain of 4 up to the 25-yard line. But you look at this defense. They sit at number 20 in the NFL right now against the run.
This is an area of the game that they definitely have to improve, because right now, against the pass, top 10 in the league. But against the run, that's where the struggles have come in. Got to find a way to make sure they stop runners before they get started.
All right. Third and 5.
Solo left Zion. Solo left Zion. Hey, 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 hey. Come on, one, hide.
They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. He's got his target. That's complete. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. A very well-executed play. It goes for 29 yards.
And that's how you shake off the interception you threw on the opening drive, come back and throw another strike and gain nice yardage. And I give credit to two people on this one. The man throwing the ball and the person calling the plays. They're not shutting him down early in this game.
A-Chain on first and 10. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 47. A great effort right from the snap there on the defensive side from Amari Barno. The Dolphins at 3-2, a game over 500 here to start the season. And they were winners their last time out, so they'll be looking to make it 2 in a row.
And so much about football, partner, comes down to mindset. Being in the right frame of mind, and the best way to get in that good frame of mind, winning. So they come in feeling good. They've got the home crowd behind them. I think they're going to be tough to beat in this one.
So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. Tua going to throw. Oh, into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked off by J.C. Horn. And the Panthers are going to get it back here just past the 35.
Well, it doesn't take a whole lot of investigation to figure out why they're still sitting at zero on the scoreboard, because their quarterback's got to wake up and start reading defense a heck of a lot better after throwing his second interception.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. Well, partner, fast forward with me for a second. Remember, next week they have the open week, so they're going to get some extended rest. Does that change how they manage the rest of this one?
I think it does a little bit, but not by too much, because you're right. You get the extra rest, you get a chance to heal up and kind of, you know, do a little bit of a reset for this team. But it's also 7 extra days to think back to the last time you were on the field. So now, a little more importance on what they're getting done, because they carry it with them for essentially 2 weeks.
Here's 2nd and 7. The chart goes in motion left. Young. Open receiver, that's Hayden Hurst, the tight end. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 14 yards, good for a Panther first down.
Hurst makes a catch, a welcome sight to the Panthers, who believe there's still growth in the 6-year tight end. Over 50 catches last season, hoping he is the field-moving tight end Carolina hasn't had since Greg Olsen's prime.